So I'm looking at the stories here that I want to talk to you about today. And we have some fascinating, fascinating guests, including the man who many believe will be the next prime minister of Israel. And I'm looking at the stories, and I have to tell you the one that has most riveted me. The liberal website Slate has just announced today. This is today, posted today. The title of the article is The Washington, and then there is a long underline. Why Slate will no longer refer to Washington's NFL team as the Redskins. And it's a long piece, and they say this is the last Slate article that will refer to the Washington NFL team as the Redskins. For decades, American Indian activists and others have been asking, urging, and haranguing the Washington Redskins to ditch their nickname, calling it a racist slur and an insult to Indians. And so they, so because of these activists saying it's a racial slur, I don't quite get how it's a racial slur. No, nobody thinks Redskins, when they say, you know, I'm a Redskin fan, they're thinking, well, the term is really a pejorative term for Native Americans or American Indians. You have to judge things by their intent, folks. And now listen to this. After this huge, huge, article, that's redundant, after this long article, here is what it says at the end, or near the end. It's precious. Here we go. So while the, it's near the end. So while the name Redskins is only a bit offensive, they acknowledge that. The Slate acknowledges it's only a bit offensive. Okay? It's extremely tacky and dated, like an old aunt who still talks about colored people or limps her wrist to suggest someone's gay. Okay. I want to talk about the colored people. Is Slate unaware of an organization on behalf of black Americans? Or I think it doesn't do much service to them, but that's not for me to judge. Well, it is for me to judge. Everybody can make a judgment, but they're not exactly calling in to ask what I think of the NAACP. But what does NAACP stand for? National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. So why don't we make a deal? The Redskins should say when the NAACP changes its name to the National Association of the Advancement of African Americans, the NAAAA, or the N-quadruple-A, then we will seriously consider dropping Redskins. The lack, I always say this, the lack of self-awareness on the left is quite extraordinary, because the self-righteousness overwhelms the ability to see things clearly and to look within. So if colored people is offensive, as offensive as Redskins, then why do we still have the NAACP? Because it's not offensive. Everything is context. Hello, hello left, context. That's why you defend or have no problem when blacks use the N-word against one another, not against, describing one another. But if a white uses it, you are against it. Now, why is that? Because context matters. Nobody, N-O-B-O-D-Y, nobody uses the term Redskin when speaking about the Washington Redskins in order to insult American Indians. The activists are bored. Almost all left-wing activists in this country find no meaning in their personal lives that comes close to the meaning that they get from activism. From, ooh, may I say, community organizing. That gives you a lot of meaning when life isn't terribly meaningful on its own. So I'm sorry, as soon as I hear the word activist, I usually think this person needs to get a life. Not always, not always. There are activists who do good work. But as a general rule, and especially from that side of the spectrum anyway, when is the last time you heard the term conservative activist? It's almost an oxymoron, because most conservatives find a lot of meaning in their lives beyond political and social activism. Imagine a conservative community organizer. The term, you know what you would do? If you heard that, you would ask, oh, really? What does he do? That's what would be asked. This is an important story. 1-8-PRAGER-776. If you feel that I have misread this, you see, the whole issue, again, is context. If people were walking around and using redskin as a pejorative for the American Indian, I would be as opposed to it as anyone on the left, because I hate bigotry as much as they do. But I also hate stupidity. They don't hate stupidity. They only hate bigotry. And only sometimes, some types of bigotry. You're allowed to be bigoted against white Southerners, for example. You can call them anything you want. You can ascribe racism to them and to their voting patterns. That's quite all right. So I read this. I think I'm going to have to write it's funny. And I guess it's a catharsis for me, because we all know that we add, you try to fight. You don't know what will work. I don't think anything will work in this particular regard. There's always a cause. The next cause, look, they don't even like, well, I'm sure Atlanta Braves will be the next one because it depicts a picture. Look. Just calling a team the Indians. Remember when President Clinton went out to throw a first ball? Was he president? I think he was president. And he wouldn't wear the Indians hat that had the cartoon character of an Indian. So he wore one that had a C on it, which made it look somewhat similar to the Cincinnati Reds hat. These are the battles. These are among the battles that they fight. I would like to ask one of the Indian activists, sir, do you believe, or ma'am, do you believe that when this term is used, it is used in order to insult your people? I think that's a very fair question. And they say, well, historically, well, wait a minute, historically colored people was. So when it says colored people in NAACP, nobody thinks that it's pejorative. So doesn't that matter? Are Indians, when a team is called the Braves or the Warriors, I'm sure they'll go after them as well. But when a team is called that, isn't it a compliment, as it were, one fights hard because that is what we ascribe to the Indians? Slate magazine has announced that this is the last time in the life of Slate that it will use the term Redskins for describing the Washington Redskins. You know, one thing about the left, you really know they are on top of the great moral dilemmas of our time. They are there fighting the evils of our day. Colored people, they use it as an example of using colored people. The NAACP has it in its title, which only proves my point that it's context. Does anybody, first of all, let's think of one other thing. When they were named after the Indians and called Redskins, was it done in order to insult American Indians or in order to emulate American Indians? Has anybody ever named a team after a group it wanted to demean? Right? It's inconceivable, correct? It has never happened. If you name yourself after a group, it is because you wish to emulate that group. So changing how you talk changes how you think, they write. The adoption of the term African-American replacing Negro and colored in the aftermath of the Civil Rights Movement brought a welcome symmetry with the Italian-Americans and Irish-Americans, groups defined by geographic origin. However, nobody goes around talking about Italian Americans and Irish Americans. The analogy is absurd. It's not used. Nobody cares. And nobody calls whites. Everybody calls whites whites. They don't think logically. You must understand, whenever I bring this to you, the left thinks emotionally. It doesn't think rationally. Every argument that they give here doesn't work. This is another example. This makes it... No, the issue isn't symmetry with Italian Americans. It's a symmetry with there are black Americans and there are white Americans, and there are blacks who don't come from Africa. They come from the Caribbean. Okay, but the Caribbean, they originally came from Africa. Well, originally, we all came from Africa. Groups defined by geographic origin, then by race or color. Obviously, what are you going to call Italian Americans in terms of race or color? It's a specific. Replacing same-sex marriage with marriage equality helped make gay marriage a universal cause. That's right. That's correct. That the left has mastered the names. See? He doesn't understand, the writer, that marriage equality changes same-sex marriage into an argument on behalf of something. But, of course, you see, if you agree with the left, then it's no longer, it's not even a cause, it's a given. So marriage equality is a given. I never really cared about this. I'm not a football fan. I'm a big hockey fan and secondarily baseball. So I just haven't gotten into football. I don't have a tortoise in this race. I acknowledge that, and I don't care about, and I don't root for any team, especially being a Los Angelino. We don't even have a team. So I have no issue here. I have no axe to grind. But now I want the team to keep the name only so as not to give in to the bullies of the left. And if Slate wants to say the Washington Dashes, that is Washington with a bunch of dashes, I think that's great. I don't know if anybody goes to this to Slate in any event. I don't know if anybody goes to Slate for sports. So let's take some calls here, and let's take the challenge here. All right. Alan, Sacramento, California. Thanks for calling.
Dennis, wonderful. Good morning. I'm a bit concerned by your inability to relate what you're saying to real-life instances. You're speaking in a vacuum. And if you just allow me quickly, I want to make one observation and then a challenge for you, and I'd love to hear your response. The first observation is, according to your logic, a team that uses the N-word spelled with an A is acceptable because contextually, no one ever uses that to offend someone. That's a term of admiration. Your logic says that that would be acceptable. And secondly, if you believe no one uses it offensively or that Native Americans aren't offended, I challenge you to take a camera crew with you or whatever it may be to your local Indian casino and ask the folks that you see around that are working for the hotel if they're Redskins. And see the response that they get. Are you a Redskin? You know, are you one of those folks?
Okay, Alan, since you and I you and I both live in 2013. Have you heard a white person use the term Redskin to describe American Indians in your life outside of the Washington Redskins? Be honest.
No. Have we ever had discussions?
Okay. Wait. Can I amplify on why that's important? It's not used. Alan, it's not used. Therefore, it's an anachronism, and therefore an anachronism is not insulting. But the N-word is insulting. So there's no comparison, since nobody uses the term Redskin. I went to a Redskin reservation the other day. They would think you went to a football training camp.
Well, Dennis, I don't hang out with people who are racist, so I wouldn't know. Secondly,
oh, come on, Alan, please,
I'm being honest.
Alan, you don't hang out with racists, but you know that the N-word is used, so don't give me that nonsense.
Well, I mean, I'm sorry, I do listen to music, and I do know it's a part of music, and I'm well aware of the debate that's being had in the black community versus the conservative community. My point is, I'm being honest with you, I haven't had those discussions with people where anyone has referenced Native Americans. In fact, my friends prefer them be called Indigenous Americans. I'm someone who went to a particular school, I got a graduate degree from said school, and I learned a lot about, you know, non-gendered language, non-offensive language.
Look, and I'm very, very seriously, I just want you to know that given your exposure to that amount of graduate school. I'm very touched that you listen to the show because it closes the mind and your mind is not closed. And I have proof that it closes the mind, that famous comment by Diana Muntz, I believe is her name, the professor at the University of Pennsylvania, did a great study and wrote a book on the subject and concluded that more graduate school you have, the fewer people you are exposed to who differ with you. But folks, nobody uses the term Redskin as an anachronism. That's why, how can an anachronism be insulting? It's not meant as an insult, it's meant as a compliment. There are people of every race and ethnicity, virtually. I mean, I don't know if there are Japanese Americans on the Redskins, but you know what I mean, on that team. Yes, exactly.